My name is Tom Sachs. I am a sculptor. I live in New York City. My work is sculpture in taxonometric terms, but I prefer to call it bricolage. Mostly self-taught in terms of technical abilities, although I've worked as a carpenter and welder. So many of the technical terms, techniques, have been things that I've developed with my team over the past 20 years. For us, our religion or our ritual is the work itself. So when you look at any of these sculptures up close, you'll see a tremendous amount of detail that does not need to be there to convey the idea, but is there because it's an expression of our work. You know, I'm tempted to talk more about bricolage because this is all made of cardboard that's reinforced with fiberglass. But probably I should speak a little about the idea behind Barbie slave ship. And that's that in the 18th century, the systems of power stole people from Africa, controlled their bodies with chains, and forced them to work in the fields, exploiting their labor to build the new world, United States, Brazil, whatever, in particular the United States, into a international superpower. In the 20th century, or 21st century, we control people's minds more than we control their bodies. Through tools like advertising, we infiltrate the mind of the consumer and even the sexuality of the consumer and sell them products that connect their sexuality to their identity as consumers. Blonde hair, blue eyes, big tits, open doors. I'm not speaking for or against this condition. I married a Barbie, who I love, but these are more conditions of our time. And so in our slave ship, we bring 200 Barbies, all named after the women who make up my mind and my imagination, who've inspired and driven me to make things. And we also have tools, which are named after good bad guys and bad good guys that also changed the world. People like Napoleon and Steve Jobs. And then we have cannons, and because although the HMS Victory, this ship, the model of the ship, was not used for slaving, it was used for enforcing the law of the day. And one of the most disturbing and dominant realities of the 18th century, of the age of sail, was slave trading. So in this piece, I intend to examine these conditions and connections between the 18th century and the 21st century, in a way, honor and respect those who suffered under these conditions, but also take those conditions of that time and the conditions of our time and try and see the association so that we can find greater meaning in our lives now. So we can say, just think a little bit before we click buy now.